everyone. A film is made in two desks. One is the script desk, another is the editing desk. A script brings out the concept and the story of the film. The editing brings a shape and harmony for the film. In this video, we will be discussing about the history of film editing. What is editing? More than a technical skill, is it an art? Editing is an art of composing space as totally or fragment, continuous or discontinuous, and time, linear or non-linear, through the arrangement, assembly and interaction of images, static or dynamic, and sounds, on screen or off screen, and an art of visualizing rhythm and tempo as emotional flow or moments of intensities. Before getting peered into editing, let me pinpoint some of its early beginnings about cameras. In 1896, the first camera with reverse cranking was invented by British pioneer Robert W. Ball. Georges Méliès was also another pioneer in and was famous for his use of multiple exposures and dissolves and was referred to as the cine magician. George Albert Smith was another film producer who used the close-up edit technique. He was also around the 1897 era. Smith was also responsible for the first use of color film process known as kinemacolor. It all started when the first motion cameras were invented in the 1890s. The Lumiere brothers kicked it all off in 1895. They invented cinematography. It was a three-way machine that recorded, captured and projected a motion picture. Moviola, the first ever actual editing machine, was invented in 1923. Before digital editing, it was analog editing. It involved cutting down the film negatives and placing them in order, and then went through a machine called the Moviola or KEM. A Moviola is a device that allows a film editor to view film while editing. It was the first machine for motion picture editing when it was invented by Ivan Seriur in 1924. Moviola, the company, is still in existence and is located in Hollywood, where part of the facility is located on one of the original Moviola factory floors. In 1997, since the time of the internet boom and computing advancements, editing has brought on a whole new meaning to film production. Previously, non-linear editing was used. Now this has been replaced by video editing software. The new editing is done digitally using software systems such as Final Cut Pro, Avid, and Adobe Premiere Pro. Advancements of technology in film camera. The Lumiere brothers held some of the earliest screenings of projected images in 1895, where their film, The Arrival of a Train at La Ciotat Station, notoriously showed a train entering a station. The French director used the techniques of superimposition of images, fading, double exposures, and scale models. Thus, he managed to produce the film A Trip to the Moon, Lee Voyage, Dans la Lune, despite the technical precariousness of the early 20th century. In 1916, one of the most important techniques of the seventh art arrived. Technicolor, which allowed filmmakers to record films in color, a key turning point for the industry, which was possible thanks to the introduction of photographic chemical process that managed to introduce color in movie frames. The technical breakthrough that made it possible was the Vitaphone.
Electrical recording device, the most sensitive part of the equipment. Its function is to impress upon the wax an exact record of the electric current produced by the original pickup microphone. This is a very delicate operation, and that accounts for the presence of the microscope, which is employed to determine the character of the cut as the work goes on. As I said before, this booth is maybe removed quite far from the actual photographing and must be soundproof both inside and out. This, I believe, covers in sufficient detail the various elements going to make up the studio equipment. And I believe you will be interested in seeing the studio in actual operation. And that is the next thing we're going to do. Are you ready, Mr. Heller?
This system, sponsored by Warner Bros. And First National Studios, allowed recording soundtracks and spoken text on desks that were then reproduced at the same time as the film. Two decades after these technological revolutions, film came face to face with what would remain its biggest competitor until the arrival of the internet, television, to counteract its popularity.
Well, that's very interesting and certainly very promising, because what we need to do is to reduce the size and the cost of these components so that television, color television, both at the transmitting and the receiving end, may be within the reach of everyone. That is my hope.
The turning point came in 1923, when Dr. Zworykin invented the iconoscope. This tube, after years of further development, became the image orthicon, the electronic eye of the modern television camera. In 1929, Dr. Zworykin and his associates announced the first successful electronic kinescope, forerunner of today's television picture tube.
Fox developed a new imaging system known as CinemaScope. This method takes large number of images by compressing a normal size within the standard 35 millimeter frame. The multiplane camera developed by UBIWorks was also introduced by Disney, allowed to provide traditional animation with at least the time innovative three-dimensional effects.
Now, this is a different kind of drawing. It also came out of our school of self-improvement here at the studio. It is the blueprint of a piece of equipment designed to make cartoons more realistic and enjoyable. This is the plan for a super cartoon camera. We call it the multiplane camera. It was intended for use in our feature-length cartoons. You see, we decided for features, the camera needed improvement too. Actually, the pre-feature cartoon camera was fairly simple in construction and operation, and generally very satisfactory. Here, a Mickey Mouse short is being put on film. Mickey has been inked and painted on transparent sheets of celluloid. This happens to be a panorama effect where the character will walk in one place and the background keeps moving behind him to create the illusion. Each time a new cell of Mickey is photographed, the background must be moved a fraction of an inch. Photographing each one of these celluloids of Mickey and background makes a single frame of motion picture film. And here's how the action looks on the screen. Now note that our character is capable of giving us a real feeling of three dimensions.
Pixar was also a symbol of animated filming since its very beginning, with its premieres such as Toy Story, Monsters Inc., and Cars. Its creations and innovations were based on the advances made in Westworld, a science fiction story famous for having used the first computer-generated graphics.
Stay back, friend. They've gotten to you, haven't they?
The future of digital cinema. The resolution of digital cinema will eventually hit 8K, which should finally quiet any digital image quality naysayers. And we should begin to see a lot more movies played back at higher frame rates like 48 and 60 FPS.
Where we hold them! This is where we fight!
The Hobbit will be the first worldwide release of a 48 FPS film shot entirely with digital red 4K cameras.
Now, we defend it.
I came to reclaim something of mine.
Thank you for watching this video.